He's already talked about the sacrifice that God has made for us. But among you, there must not be even a hint of sexual immorality. Beginning in this verse, all the way down to probably about verse 7, is this put off and put on business, again, that you saw in the latter part of 4. He doesn't use that terminology, but that's his idea. And he tells us all kinds of things that we need to put off, some things that do not fit the character of God. When you want to talk about what sin is, sin, we see the word hamartia, falling short, missing the mark. Trespass, we get off the road. If you want to find what sin is, it's something that is ungodly, that is not like God. The whole idea, even in the Old Testament, of what God wants, do you remember the phrase that's mentioned many times? Be you holy as I am holy.
Check out the new series, Hymns of Hope, on Praise and Harmony TV today. In this 6-part series, Jeff Walling takes us on a journey through studying the Psalms and how they integrate with our modern worship.
Not about the songs that were written maybe in the last 100 years or even in the last 1,000 years. No, we're going to reach back more than 2,000 years to Israel's hymnal, their hymnal of hope.
Enjoy timeless stories about how we got some of our most beloved songs.
When finally the telegram came through, and it's a famous one, it just had 2 words on it. The words came from Horatio Spafford's wife, and the 2 words were, saved, alone.
And sing along with the Praise and Harmony singers. Check out Hymns of Hope on Praise and Harmony TV today.